Good morning, my name is Joanna Aviles, and I'm going to be talking about serial killers. So, do any one of you guys know what's the difference between a serial killer and an actual murder? Well, one of the main differences between a serial killer and a murder is that serial killers usually tend to kill more than one victim. And not only that, but there's times where they would keep on killing more than 20 victims in a murder. He only usually kills one victim and he can get caught by the police at an early age. So, for the background information, there's actually no way to actually figure it out when it actually serial killer started began, because there have been many cases where serial killers have happened in our society, and usually serial killers would tend to commit really vicious crimes against innocent victims or victims that they think that they should attack. So first I'm going to talk about the characteristics, motives, and the reasons why serial killers usually attack. And I'm also include examples in real life shows that are actually based on serial killers. So first I'm going to talk about the motives. So I included some pictures which are based on motives in which serial killers commit their crimes. So one side, if you guys see, there's like an eye, which is a green eye. So there's this story about green-eyed monsters, which represents jealousy. So in some cases, serial killers usually tend to kill because they're jealous of other people, or they usually tend to kill because they've been in a relationship and their relationship didn't work out, because they will find out that their wife is usually cheating on a person. So they will tend to kill. Not only that, but there's times where a person would pretend to be happy or look like they're happy, but in reality they're struggling inside with mental issues, or they just think that it's fun or it's a game for them to be innocent people. And there's other cases where serial killers usually kill because their family is going through hardships, or it's not like kind of like well developed. So so according to according to the National Center for Analysis of Violent Crime, there's this one most famous case, which is called Jake the Reaper, in which he would kill his victims for fun and drill, and he would usually taunt the police by sending messages of his victim and what he's doing to the victim. And for him, he would describe that, well, his main target would usually be like prostitutes, because he had a thing for them, and in his case, he had a girlfriend, and like, he found out that he cheated on him. So he took away his anger by going against all prostitutes and would kill them like in a brutal way. And as you can see, there's this one picture on the side, that's him. He was usually described as a tall guy dressed all in black, and he would be a very mysterious creature. And there's another case, I don't know if you guys heard about the story of Killing Hyde, which is usually one person who has dull personality. So like on one side of his face, he's usually like it's Jekyll, which in the morning, he's like, oh, he's considered like a nice doctor and everything. He's friendly and outgoing towards his whole patients. But then at night, he will turn into like an evil doctor, which his name would change, would be called Hyde. So there's been some cases in which people suffer from dull personalities. And in some of the cases, the people who tend to deal with dull personalities would they don't have control of themselves. So like witnesses don't know like if they're like safe or not, like to be around. Or they usually get sent to institutes where they try to help them. But in most cases, most serial killers don't try to seek for help. So they will hide everything inside with them. And this is a graph of the modern day murders by the number of victims, which is fairly like recently. So the red, like where it's on the bottom, auto red part, it's like the amount of victims they have killed. So the most victims they killed right now was by, well, Pedro Lopez, who's from Colombia, and he has killed in Colombia, but Peru, Ecuador has killed more than 300 persons. And his most of his tactics were used through gunshot, knife attack, and poisoning, and at the same time they used torture. So on this side, well, on the sides are like the methods they will use, like against their victims, and on the, like the, each one of them is from different locations or countries. So serial killers are not only like the United States or like every, like there's different serial killers out there in the world where they are different race, language, and everything. So. Okay, not only that, but serial killers have been based on popular TV shows. They're based on real life. So one example is about American Horror Story, which is based on serial killers. So on one of the side, there's the character in American Horror Story is called James March. And in real life, his real name is Henry Holmes. And the story of the American Horror Story is based about the hotel. So it was actually created in real life. And he would get his victims into a hotel. And in his hotel, there would be different sections of rooms where he would like go against the victims. And then Lady Gaga's character, which is Elizabeth, is actually based on a real life event that happened in 1580, long time ago, and he would actually torture their victims at the same time.